So what is intracranial pressure? What can cause elevated intracranial pressure, and why is this such a problem? Basically, intracranial pressure is the amount of pressure within the cranium caused by the brain tissue, blood within the brain cavity, and cerebral spinal fluid, or CSF. Now, we need a specific pressure within there. Normal pressure is 5 to 15 millimeters of mercury. What can happen, however, is if a patient develops a tumor, for example, that's going to take up some of this space within here. Or if the patient has a hemorrhagic stroke and they begin to bleed within their cavity here. Or if they have a ischemic stroke and this tissue starts to swell. So those types of things can cause intracranial pressure to rise. Now, why is this such a concern? So if you were to damage your wrist, if I were to hit my wrist and cause damage to my wrist, this could swell. There's space, it's soft tissue, it can swell, and when it heals, as it heals, it will begin to decrease in swelling. Now the problem with the brain, of course, is that we have a cranium. Okay, we have a skull. The skull is hard, this is bone, it's thick, and that's a good thing. That serves as protection for us in our normal daily life. However, when we experience injury, when we experience head trauma, stroke, tumor, whatever else, that hard bone here prevents the brain from being able to swell as would normally happen in another, like the ankle or a wrist that becomes damaged. So what can happen is as that starts to swell, our intracranial pressure rises. Now as that pressure rises, for example, if we have a tumor or blood building up here, it will start to compress our brain. And our brain will actually shift over, okay? As that blood fills up in here, our brain's gonna shift over. Now as that happens, that starts to interfere with normal neurological function. Okay, so once ICP, once intracranial pressure reaches 20 to 25 millimeters of mercury, intervention is needed. One thing that can be done is a catheter can be placed into the brain and into the ventricle, allowing extra fluid and blood to drain off and out. Other things that can be done, for example, in ischemic strokes, as the patient starts to swell a few days after the stroke, they can actually remove a portion of the bone here, and that will allow the brain tissue to swell and to be damaged. And then as the tissue starts to recover, they can replace the bone and then the patient can move on with their life. So that is why intracranial pressure is so important. We need normally between 5 and 15 millimeters of mercury. As it starts to rise, the problem is there is nowhere for this expansion, this swelling, this fluid to go because of our skull. And so that becomes a very real concern for our patients. So some of the interventions, like I said, we can do the bone flap. We can do an intraventricular catheter, which is, it actually drills through the skull and you put a little catheter right here in the ventricle and that allows fluid to drain out. You can also get medications, osmotic diuretics like mannitol, which will help decrease the amount of fluid, draw the fluid out of here and get it out of the body. But those are some of the interventions, and that is why increased intracranial pressure is such a concern. Hey guys, it's John with NRSNG.com. Thanks for stopping by and checking out our YouTube channel. Be sure to subscribe so you find out about all of our new videos as they come out. Listen, nursing school doesn't have to be so hard. That's why I created NRSNG.com. When I was in nursing school, I became so frustrated with administration that just didn't seem to care, professors that didn't know the content or just read from PowerPoints, and so many other problems. So NRSNG was created to give you the tools, the support, and the guidance, and the community that you need as a nursing student to accomplish your goal of becoming a nurse. Nursing is awesome. In my time as a nurse, I've worked as a charge nurse, a preceptor, I'm an RN, a CCRN, and I've done so much with my career, and I want to give back to you guys. So be sure to subscribe, check out the free book down below, 140 Must Know Meds, and be sure to check out the other videos that other students have found very helpful. You guys, thank you so much for stopping by. You can do this. Nursing is an awesome career, and I hope to see you around.